Hello everybody, so happy to welcome you to our favorite mixed media YouTube hub. And here is our banner with the list of sponsors. Thank you so much because the sponsors have been generous for this YouTube hub. And apart from the mixed media products you can also win some of the beautiful projects created by some of the artists taking part in this hub. I'm gonna be working with some products from some of the sponsors, not all of them because, well, that's impossible. But I have a few of them here, and that's 7 Dot Studio, AB Studio, Snipart, and of course Lindis. I'm working in my small art journal, and before starting the work I prepare my pages. I glue a few of the pages together with a double-sided tape. And now I'm gonna put a layer of clear gesso over the pages to avoid seeping through the page. The gesso dries very quickly, so I'm working already on the second step. I'm using a matte gel from PBO and I'm gonna be adding some tissue paper by Tim Holtz. And I'm doing that also with a card, like that I can spread it evenly. And I just tear random pieces of papers without thinking too much. I want to do it two pages. And so I'm gluing them on both sides. And to make the coverage better, I'm gluing also, I'm adding the matte gel also on top of the paper. Now I'm gonna be doing some stamping. I'm using Paper Artsy stamp designed by Kim Delo. Kim Delo is one of the artists also who is taking part in this hub. And to do so I'm using Jet Black Archival ink. Again, more stamping. This time it's a joy stamp called Wild African. And at the beginning I'm using acrylic block to transfer the stamp, but later, because it's a double page, so it has the crease in the middle, it's much easier when I'm doing it by hand, so I remove the acrylic block and I'm stamping the image just using my hand. I'm gonna also add some white gesso, that's a gesso from PBO, just to cover a little bit the writing, the stamping, just to give a little bit more of interest to the page. And just because I'm impatient, I will not even dry the gesso, I will apply a stencil now. That's a stencil from AB Studio. And again, the full list of products you'll find on my blog post and in the description box below. So you have all the names or numbers of the products I used, which I find is always a help. And I'm gonna be using a sand paste, also from PBO. And this paste is not very thick, so it's easy to spread over the stencil. And it gives this something different than a modeling paste because it has these small grains inside. And you have to remember that if you wanna add the colors later, the paste actually is gonna take the color which you add. And now I'm using a Crystal Effect Mortar by Renaissance and I'm spreading it with my palette knife. This paste is white when you're spreading it and there are big crystals, so it's very hard to work with it and with a stencil. That's what I'm using a palette knife, but later it will give you, after drying it will give you these crystals encrusted to the page. And before I'm drying it, I'm also adding a little bit of obviously black embossing powder by Lindis. Lindis is also Lindis Gang is also one of our sponsors. And I dried everything with a heat gun, but it takes a long time to dry it. And maybe it's better to leave it overnight. But I'm gonna be adding colors, so I spray the page with the water. And now I'm adding Magical Shaker by Lindis. This is Oktoberfest Orange. So I'm sprinkling it all over the page and I'm adding again a little bit of water. And for this project I wanted to use mainly two colors, orange and purple. So this one is a Starburst French Lilac Violet, also from Lindisgang. And I'm splattering the paint because I don't want it to cover all of the paper. And like that I have more control. And now I'm just gonna use my mini mister to add some water, and like that the paints can flow a little bit more freely. And again I need to dry everything. When everything is perfectly dry, I will add again more stamping. This time I'm gonna emboss the stamp from Viva Las Vegas, and I'm using one embossing pad and again obviously black embossing powder by Lindis. I was not very happy with the end effect, so I removed a little bit of the stamping image with my brush, and now I can dry it. And again some more stamping, again with a jet black archival ink. I don't know the name of this stamp. It's a little steampunk stamp. You have an image of a hand and the image of the clock. And I really like black, so I wanted to also add as much black as possible to the page. And I'm adding Remnants Wraps also by Tim Holtz. I didn't show you all the process because well, it takes me. It took me some time to wrap the remnants onto the page. They are not very easy, but I had 3 numbers only, and you're gonna see it now, or 1, 0, and 3. And I'm gonna be adding a black gesso by Fabrica de Coru, and I'm using again the palette knife. Time to work on my embellishments, which is always, to be honest, the most difficult part for me because I prefer to do the stamping, do the backgrounds. So I'm covering now with black gesso Animal Skull from Metal, and now I'm using MDF from Snipart. Snipart is again one of our generous sponsors, and I love to play with MDF because they are much sturdier than chipboards and much easier to work with. So I'm gonna be embossing them with obviously black embossing powder. And for the embellishments I decided to add Opal Magic Blue Velvet Wax. So I'm using my finger. I love to work with my fingers. I can feel the texture, I can feel where the paint or the wax is going. And I'll do the same with the skull. And for those who know me, you know already what's gonna happen next. Since I have a black paint in my hand, I'm gonna be doing splatter, of course. And again, I wanna make the page as dark also as possible. It's not that I have a dark soul or something like that. I just really like the black color on the pages I'm creating. So I'm adding quite often a lot of black accents, and here I add the thread. Yes, it's a thread. I add pieces of thread, and I'm adding die cuts from AB Studio, another of our sponsors. And this die cut is coming from the collection Vintage Elements. I'm gluing it with a tacky glue. And I'm fighting a lot with the thread because, well, it's hard to glue it to the page, and I wanted to make a shape, kind of shape out of it. So again, the tacky glue is coming in handy. And that's the second die cut, also from the collection Vintage Elements by AB Studio. And now I am gonna be adding the MDF, which I prepared earlier. And the stone, well, the stone is not gonna stay there. It's just my weight to glue the elements. And this is another of our sponsors, 7 Dot Studio. So I'm gonna be using word stickers. And I decided to use 3 word stickers from the collection Hazy Days. And I cut them a little to make them a tiny bit smaller without cutting the words, of course, just the edges. And I'm also inking the edges with the archival ink. And to be sure they'll stack well to the page, I'm adding a layer of tacky blue also. So that's it. My very dark art journal page is finished. And I really hope you're gonna play with us. And you'll find all the information on how to play in the description box below or in the on our blogs. But basically what we would like for you to do is to subscribe to our channels if you haven't done so already, and to comment on our creations. And thank you again to our generous sponsors, and thank you for taking your time and playing with us and watching what we created. See you soon. Bye.